fans, time to leave your seat. Get on your feet. The wave lap for the wheel hiking ground pounding Summit Racing Equipment UMP late models. As they come through, turn number four. Make some noise. What do you say, Attica? Raceway! Gentlemen, kids of all ages, it's time to jump and jive for 25. Matt Irie, Ryan Missler, side by side for the lead. Irie drives up the racetrack, but Missler off the cushion leads lap number one. Ryan Missler looking for his second win of the season. What a race for the four spot, Casey Noonan. Kent Brewer, Devin Shields, and Jim Gingery. Miss a big lead. All right, Missler bobbles on the cushion. Here comes Matt Irie. Devin Shields now up to the third spot. Ryan Missler and Matt Irie battling for the lead. Here comes Devin Shields in the third. Anthony Kincaid into the fourth spot. Don't look now, but hammer down. Doug Drown has picked up five spots in the last two laps, up to the fifth position. Missler on the cushion, Irie in the middle of the racetrack. Shields right off the rear deck lid of Irie. Doug Drown into the top five. Nine laps go in the books this time by for Ryan Missler. Three fly down the backstretch. Ryan Missler with 10 laps in, 15 to go. Missler with about a seven car length advantage, but he's got two lap cars racing side by side in front of him. Down to complete lap number 12, 13 to go. Missler going to be patient with the lap cars. Now a lap car separate the top two. Missler being delicate with the six of Jimmy Ward. Gets a little sideways right in front of your leader. Here comes Matt Irie. Irie putting the pressure on Missler, trying to get around the six of Jimmy Ward. Going to show him his nose. Going to hit him in turns three and four for the lead. Ryan Missler uses up the lap car. Irie into the lead. Now your leader. Missler staying close though. Eight laps to go. Here comes Missler. Oh, they tried the slider in one and two, couldn't make it stick. They run the cushion in three and four. Here comes Doug Drown on the bottom. We got a four-car battle for the lead. Throw a blanket on them down the backstretch. Matt Irie, Ryan Missler, Doug Drown, and Devin Shields. Six laps to go. Doug Drown has found something on the bottom of the racetrack. He pulls to the inside of Matt Irie for the lead. Five laps to go. Will we have a new leader? Matt Irie holds him off. Drown to the inside, out of turn two, sticks a nose out front into three and four. Irie goes back to the cushion. Four laps to go this time by. Here comes Missler to make it a three-car battle. Drown again down to the bottom of one and two. But he's got lap cars running that bottom line with three laps to go. Drown's going to have to do something here once he catches the 17 and the 30. Of the season. Goes up to the cushion now in three and four. White flag for Doug Drown. Drown down the backstretch one final time. In a race that's going to go green, the checker slider for second for Ryan Missler. In a race that took just about 7 minutes. 7 minutes, Doug Drown. You know, I don't know if you were biding your time back there or what you were doing, but it seemed like the last six or seven laps you got shot out of a cannon on that one.
Yeah, I was searching around. I mean, obviously points coming in tonight was tied, and I don't want to think about it. All I want to do is win races. And when you had Ryan, Shields, somebody else, and I back here in that back four, and it was going to be a dogfight getting Matt Irie there, and it was just a dogfight. And, you know, I admit, the guys are all over the place. I mean, that was the best of the best here at Attica, minus Rusty. But that was a pumped-up race because normally I don't go to the bottom, but this car was just digging. And the guys talked me into it, Cody, to let's not touch much because I always over Justin. Tonight we had a really fast hot rod, and it could go anywhere.
The last three laps, you could see a couple of lap cars running the bottom, so you had to go up to the top. Were you concerned at all about that?
Not really, because running up top earlier in the race, and I knew you had to pedal the car, and I think that's what a lot of the guys that were gassing it up too much and just spinning a little bit. So I was trying to pedal the car, and really the thing hooked up. So phenomenal job. I know it was a little dusty on this once the wind changed, but as far as on a racetrack for us racers, it was phenomenal for the way things have been. You know, I know Pork Chop and those guys have been fighting, but appreciate all the fans coming out this 4th of July weekend, and I want to thank 89 Homes, Ely Road Reel, Worcester Glass, ABR Farms, who's here tonight, Hoosier Racing Tires, Black Diamond Chassis, Tegra Shocks, Keith Berner, AccuForce, and Linda Burns. We were not a half a bubble off tonight.
His third win of the season, 27th of his career, takes over sole possession of the all-time win list for the late models here now at Attica Raceway.